Hey everybody, this is Michael with Asymmetrical Preparedness. Thank you very much for being here. I really appreciate you guys. For all your awesome comments, for all your subscribership, all your support, you guys rock. Team AP is awesome. I really appreciate you guys. This video is the long road home in SHTF, meaning you're far from home. You're a long ways from home. And I'm more thinking a WROL situation, although a lot of these situations, they don't just boom happen overnight. You know, it takes a while for them to grow and to percolate and to, you know, to go down. There are some things that would be immediate, like an EMP, bam, foreign invasion, bam, nuclear war, bam, those kind of things. But most situations, or vast majority of situations, take a while to grow, to build steam before you're really in a tough situation and really in a hard time. So with that said, just don't travel far from home if things are going bad. If you can absolutely help it. If something happens quick, you don't know it. You may be, you know, halfway across country on a business trip or something like that, or visiting relatives, and the rest of your family's at home. It's a really bad situation to be in, a really bad situation. Odds are you're not going to make it home, depending on the distance. I'll be honest with you. I'm not trying to, you know, build fear in you or anything like that. It's just, it is what it is. But let me talk about some things, and we'll go over some ideas, some things for you guys to think about, because every situation is different. Also, it depends on where you are. You know, are you on a hunting trip in the outback of Alaska in the freezing tundra, and your family's in Miami? The odds of getting home on foot are zero, pretty much. Sorry. But, or are you like 50 miles away? Is that a long road home for you? It all depends. So the first thing is, what do you have? What do you have with you? Do you have a bug out bag? Did you fly there? So all that you have is your luggage. Are you in your vehicle? So you have your vehicle also. Does your vehicle still work? There's a lot of things. So what do you have with you? You got to assess this. And anytime you're leaving on a trip away from your home, assess what you take with you. Take with you as much as you can. But be smart about it. You can't carry everything. You can't carry everything in the kitchen sink. Okay. What kind of event? It depends. What kind of event? Is it just an SHTF type thing, like a big hurricane comes through and blocks the road or takes out a bridge or something, and you're just it takes you longer to get home? Or is it a situation where it's EMP, like the entire country's black? Well, you know, because there's no lights. There's no power. Well, and that's not even the case, because an EMP isn't 100% effective. There will still be power in certain areas. Some things will still work. Some vehicles will still work, stuff like that, especially older vehicles. I'm sure you guys know that. Do you know how to get home from where you are? Have you war gamed this in advance? And I know this maybe seems like a little overkill and a little like, wow, that guy's weird. He thinks he's going to plan out every single thing. No, you can't. But if you're going to be making a trip and you think something is likely to happen, or maybe your NSHTF is slowly growing, you know there's a threat out there, then prepare yourself. If you're going to, you know, to this point and your home is this point, make sure you have all the maps of the areas in between the two points. Make sure you have a compass. Make sure you have a bug out bag. Make sure you have as much as you possibly can so that you are able to find your way back home. That's a big point. How are you going to find your way back home? Planned out routes. War game in your head. Say, you know, these are the 3, 4, 5 different routes I could possibly take. Because you don't know. Say you're driving and you're halfway home. But if you have these routes written down, then you can break out your map, say, okay, I'm here. Well, this route ahead of me is not good. It's compromised. So I can, you know, I can hedge over here. I can head out over here, and I can start taking this route. If you have map and compass, you can do that. If you don't, well, you're going to have to figure things out on the fly, and that's not a very good situation to be in. So do you have maps? Do you have a compass? Do you know routes? What about threats in the area? Did you do a threat assessment of the areas in between here, here and here? Do you know that, okay, this is a big city and there's a lot of bad happening in the city, a lot of bad stuff going on? Or are you rural and there's a tiny town here, but not many people with spread out farms? It all depends on that. What is the weather like? Is it in the middle of summertime? Are you in the desert? Are you in the middle of winter and you're in the Arctic? I mean, there's things to think about. So this is all what if. I can't give you all the answers. I'm trying to get you to think. So, distance. Also, is it viable to walk all the way home? If you're 600 miles from home, is it viable to walk? mean, if you got to do it, you got to do it, right? But, you know, what about a bicycle or something? I mean, something to make your trip faster, a horse. I don't know. There's so many variables, like I said. Planning the trip is vital, though. What you take, and like I said, building the routes back home is important. Make plans like this before you travel, because you never know when something's going to happen. If you have a couple contingencies laid out, and then you travel, you may be better off. If you didn't think about it at all, well, then you may be SOL. So identify routes. Also, along the routes, water sources, food sources, along with the threat potentials of each route. That's very important, because you're going to have to have water. So what should you take with you? Like a Sawyer Mini water filter, right? Yeah, okay. Because you're not going to be able to carry water to walk 600 miles. Sorry, this ain't going to happen. This is a very complex issue. There are many variables. Are you driving? Are you walking? Are you armed? That's a big one. Are you armed? Are you able to be armed? Did you drive there? If you drove there, then you can bring your guns with you. Or if you live in a country where you don't have guns, I don't know. You know, whatever else you have. If you flew there, you may not have your guns, though. So that's something to think about. What about food? How much food are you starting off with? How much water are you starting off with? Also, containers for water that you find along the way. You got to have something to put them in, right? You can't just drink and then immediately and then walk and then be out of water down the road. You got to be able to carry it with you. So filters. Where are you? What time of year? What's the terrain? What's the, how hot does it get during the day? How cold does it get at night? How are you dressed? Are you dressed appropriately? Are you layered for warmth? Are you, do you have proper footwear? All these kind of things. If you're going on a business trip somewhere, yeah, I get it. You get your wingtips and your suit. But throw in a pair of hiking boots and some jeans and a t-shirt or something like that and some layering, some base layer and stuff. Throw in a ball cap, whatever. All these kind of things you got to think about. A lot of times you're going to stay gray, right? You want to be a gray man. You just want to be sliding through the area without anybody paying any attention. You don't want bright clothing. You don't want fancy clothing. You don't want trashy clothing. You're just going to want to be in the middle. Just average Joe. That's what you want to be. Subtle. Yeah, you want to travel unseen. Stick to safe routes. You may have to travel at night. You may want to travel during the day. You may want to use micro terrain, which is like traveling along ditches and depressions and in valleys and ravines and places that doesn't get you seen as much. Back alleyways, although that could be an issue also. Routes that people may not think about, not obvious routes. Don't just be walking down the interstate. That's probably not a good idea, depending on the situation. Maybe it is. Like I said, there's a lot of variables. Stick to safe. Yeah, so try to remain undetected, of course. You don't want to be detected because you don't know who's good, who's bad, who has, good in their hearts for you or harm, wants to do you harm. So travel day and night, it depends. Odds are against it if it's WOL, without rule of law, and how much distance you have to travel. Because then people are just going to be losing their minds everywhere. There's not going to be law enforcement out, so people are going to be doing whatever they want, whenever they want. So that a lot of bad people take advantage of that. What are your foraging skills like? Do you know what wild edibles there are in this location, in between your two locations? How do you find food? Because you're not going to be sitting there, doing a lot of trapping and stuff like that also, trapping or snaring, because you're going to be on the move. You may be able to set up a trap or snare while you're sleeping, and maybe it'll pay off. If you have a firearm, you can hunt along the way. If you're walking along and you see a deer sitting there, well, if you're in a WRL situation, shoot it. Make a fire, cook it, eat it, stuff like that. Carry it with you. And don't trim the fat in a situation like that. A lot of people are like, oh, I don't want to eat the fat. That fat is vital. Fat will keep you alive. You don't want to eat just lean protein because you'll still starve to death. Don't throw away the fat. Keep the fat. I would throw away some of the meat before I throw away the fat. Keep all the fat you can, and then maybe throw away some of the meat if you can't carry it all. But carry as much as you can. If you need to make a travoy, make a travoy. What is a travoy? It's those, two sticks going like here, one across, lash it together, tie it, hook it, and drag it behind you like the Indians did, Native Americans. They drug them behind their horses or on foot. You could put supplies on there. If you can't carry all the gear and you got, or all the meat, you got sticks, you got trees, you got some cordage, you got some 550 cord, of course, because you're a prepper, right? Yep, right here, see, 550 cord. Take it off, take this apart, spool it out, tie them together, lash it down there, lash your extra meat, whatever, extra water bottles, you found a really good water source, this kind of stuff, and then drag it behind you so you don't have to have it on your pack. You could even throw your pack on there and just drag it so then you can walk much quicker and be much more effective, right? Yes. you have a means to hunt? Which means firearm, bow, crossbow, something like that. High power air rifle, maybe. What about teaming up with others headed in the same direction? That may be a good idea. It may be a bad idea. Because you know, if you don't, do you know the people or not? That it's a touchy situation, whether or not you can rely on others. You may be able to, you may not. So it's going to be a judgment call. You're going to have to judge those people. Not judge them. You're going to have to, analyze them, think, and mitigate any issues that you think might be upcoming. You're going to have to make a quick, judge of character, what kind of people they are. It may be good to be in a group if you're moving in the same direction. Move together, be mutual supporting and stuff like that, because lone wolf is not that good of an option. You got to sleep sometime. You can't set security 24/7. There may be more issues with that revolving around conflicts, personality conflicts, conflicts of interest, conflicts of where to go, how to go, what to do, food available, water available, stuff like that. But I still think you'd probably be better off if you can find somebody that you can safely travel with. So this is kind of my take on Long Road Home. It's a very difficult situation with a lot of variables and a lot of difficulties. The only thing we can do as preppers is to take with us as much as we can that will work and that we need. And then check out, gather intel on the areas in between where we're going and home. Because just in case, it's a little out there for most people. They're like, I don't ever do that. Well, yeah, most people don't. And then most people will die in an SHTF or WRL situation because of that. The sheeple will die. That's why we're preppers. That's why we're here. That's why you're here, right? I'm trying to lift you up and I'm trying to empower you guys with knowledge so that you can be in the asset column instead of the liability column. All right, I love you guys. Prep a little every day and prep it a peace of mind out of fear. Blessings to you and yours.